못하네. 그리워 그때 밤 우리 들만의 들만의 길이를 갖춘 고민을 담아 떠올랐 구름에 그린 팔레트. 그리워 그때 밤 우리 들만의 들판의 홀로와 빛났던 순간을 담아 띄어날 꿈은 내 파고 뭘 위해서 You know the rules boom 있는 길에서 움직여 구구 일단 앞으로 뭘 위한 건지도 모를 벗어나 불을 고선 밤새도록 all night 비워내 내 맘속에 불 끄고 비웠던 꽃잎밖에 떠올릴 게 없어 이 넓은 들판에 처음 만났던 그때로 돌아가 그때의 나에게 해주고 싶은 말이 지금 하나 생각나는 걸 그땐 알 수 없던 걸 계속 달려봤자 결국 돌아보는 걸 지금 이때를 짧을 이 밤을 지나가기 전에 잡아 지나면 못 감아 다시 돌아오지 않아
Welcome back, good peoples of the world. It is Sunday morning here in Ohio State land. See the Ohio State land right there, baby? OH! OH! We did get some good news yesterday that I guess supposedly they're thinking that this fall they will have full stadiums for the football games, which is really, really good. Now that I'm back in Ohio, I can actually go to a football game, although I'll be honest, for all those football fans out there, I've never understood, and this kind of goes into concerts as well, I never understood going to the game other than the social aspect of it. Like, if you want to go to a game and just feel like the crowd, amazing sound, and all that other stuff, and, like, I guess get into the game spirit, I can understand that. But to watch the game, it's just not good. It's so much better on TV. I mean, I guess you get to hear like the hitting and stuff like that if you're close to the field, but like most people can't afford to like be close to the field. It's kind of the same thing with iView concerts. So obviously your DVDs of seeing John Petrucci do this like up front like that to me is way better than actually going to a concert where you're sitting in the back row and you can't see shit. Now, if you've got the money, the caveat to that is if you have the money to sit right up in front, then yes, that's totally different because now you're getting the whole thing. You're getting like the crowd feel, the live feel, and you're still getting to see them do actually what they do, which is amazing. So I don't know. I'll probably go to a game, but if I don't go to a game, I'm not gonna be like, oh man, this sucks. Because especially these days, like in order to just pay for the live experience, it's getting so ridiculous. Like even Dream Theater, I remember when I was going to see Dream Theater a lot back in early 2000s and 98, through early 2000s, I was going quite a bit. I think their concert ticket, I think the one I went to in Chicago, we're talking Chicago. The one I went to in Chicago was $40 for the ticket for general admission, $40. And I was like right in front of John Mayung and I was right in front of John Petrucci on the railing. So now, I at least in Seoul, and Seoul's kind of an exception because they just rip everything off for concerts, but in Seoul, the last time I saw them when they came for the Dramatic Turn of Events tour, it was the only time I saw them in Seoul. It was, I'm not joking, $130. And it was like a seat and it was like probably middle of the I could not see them. I couldn't see like, I could see their bodies and moving around and stuff like that. But all you would see is like this, like just a hand going like that. You didn't know what was going on. So to me, would never do that again. We'll never pay that much money for that kind of experience because call me spoiled, but I just think that's a ripoff for that kind of situation. So I don't know what it is here in the States. Did anybody go see Dream Theater lately in the last like couple I don't know, years or whatever? Like, are their tickets kind of way up there now since they've gotten more popular? I mean, are we talking $90, $100, or are we still talking in the 45 range? Because I'd be interested. Because if they do come around, I'm going to go see them again, depending on the price ticket and if it's general admission. Because if they get rid of general admission, you just sit there and watch. Not a fan of that stuff. I'd rather just watch a DVD. All right, so let's get off that track and let's get back on listening to our pay-for-plays today. We have got five pay-for-plays today. Yeah, so the first one up for us today is from Max Maiden. Yes, he is going to come back with another song. This will be the second time that we have listened to this band. But before I say what the band is, before we get into the music reaction, I want to show you guys something. I spent 2 hours yesterday, yes, 2 hours, because the suggestions were I should keep a list of bands that I've listened to. So I went back and kind of organized it. I couldn't go all the way back because it was just taking way too long. So it took me 2 hours and I got this far. So let's see if you can see it. There you go. So behind me, you should be able to see this. You can see like the date. You can see the band that was requested and you can see the song and by what customer. I'm calling them customers. By what, because I was going to put subscribers, but I didn't know. Like, they may not be subscribers, so. And these are all the people that have paid, and like, it's the list keeps going down. It took me 2 hours to go back through everything and try to figure out who did what, and there's still a couple songs that I missed that I couldn't necessarily get. So, yeah, we're going to add to that list today because Max has picked Vulcan once again to come back, and here we go. Let's listen to Vulcan. Like it so far. Nice. Boom, boom, boom. Oh, wow. Like that.
I see burning ships.
Yes. Like it so far.
I have seen,
yes,
the pictures that you draw me. Oh, they're so dark and warm.
This is a great intro to a song. Part reminds me of this Christian band I listen to called Pray for Rain, PFR. Just his voice and the effect on his voice, and then just the rim shots. Sounds like a few of their songs. I'm loving this so far. You can feel it building. Hear that low bass? Yes, building slowly. Incubus sound again.
I
I feel like these transitions are working together for me. Yeah. It's keeping me, like, engaged for sure. Would be nice for it to move into something more home basey. I mean, we're 4 minutes in almost. Yes, Adrian, spelled with a K though, not a C. Parts and I like the feel of the song, but I'm starting to like want it to get more of a hook. I'm not feeling hooked yet. Keep going from part to part to part and they're all cool, but it's like, where's the solid part? Nice build there. I mean, they just keep going from section to section, and all the sections are really tight and good, just not connected in a woods sort of way. Guitar solo? Oh, I like that. Oh. Did you hear that bass? That sounded cool. A 70s kind of sound. I really like their parts. I mean, they've got some really good sections. Let's go. Oh, I messed up. Oh no. Let me get to the middle. Oh, I messed up. Sorry about that. I didn't mean to click on it. Sorry, we're gonna have to listen to this part again. Back to the guitar solo. For a second time. Is that again? Yeah, Adrian. I'm looking forward to it. We got another 2 minutes, Mr. Gabriel, another 2 minutes. Definitely getting bored. Definitely some cool sections in that song for sure. Lots of cool sections. I'd say almost all the sections were cool. Just not a well-written song. For me. Sounds like it's raining there too. All right, sorry about that mess up, folks. That's what happens when you go live. So the downside to live was just seen. Not only did we have to start the song at a different spot again, but you got to see who's coming next, but that's okay. Okay, so this is what I was thinking throughout the song, because it started out, and I think everybody was like, yeah, this is really good, yeah. And then it just was like, okay, where, and I even said it. I was like, okay, it'd be nice to get to a home base. It'd be nice to have like a hook or something like that. And yeah, it just never came. And so then I had this thought. So it seems kind of annoying, I should say, maybe from an outsider, because I was thinking of like what someone else would say that really loves the song. Man, what is every song have to have a hook? Man, why does every song have to be the same thing? Why can't you have... I get it, but you do. It's got to have a structure to it. It's like, that's like saying like, and this is what made me think in my reaction to it. is if somebody said that, I would say, yes, every once in a while, it's good to go off and do something completely different, right? So I agree with that. Every once in a while, you got to have like this bleep of getting outside of the norm in any kind of art. But the thing is, like, you're taking a big risk in doing that, because if you're going to do that and you're going to go off and do something that's not your typical ABA hook, da-da-da-da kind of thing, then it's got to be so good that it defies the reality of what you're supposed to do and kind of defines something new. But then you can't keep doing that, because then that becomes the repetition, right? So let me say this. Last night, this was interesting to me. My wife and I, we watched Minari. Minari is that Korean movie, because of course she's Korean, and we were going to watch it because it won awards, I think, and Brad Pitt was the one who directed it. And she won, and the old lady that won, she's been in a lot of Korean shows when I lived in Korea, so I'm very familiar with her. And she won, like, Best Actress or something like that? She won some award for that movie. And so when we went to go watch it, I was like, this must be a pretty good movie. I mean, if it won all these awards or whatever. And we watched it. Number one, that was the boringest movie I've ever seen. Number two, it didn't even tell a fuck. I mean, the story was, and the reason it was so boring was because it didn't follow the typical, like, you know, conflict resolution, climax, a conflict, you know, like it didn't follow the whole, like, mountain of a story, which is fine. Again, like, this is why I'm talking about this. If you're going to do that and you're not going to follow the typical storyline of the way stories are told and movies are told, then it better be really good. This was not. Like, it was so weird. It was like, what is this movie even about? It was like, okay, so it's about this guy who's starting a farm, da-da-da. The conflict, I guess, was when the barn burned, but then the resolution was just they found the Minari. It was so, like, non-connecting, non-emotional. I was like, and what did the woman actress do that was so worthy of a like some award or something? The acting was not that good. Like, it just wasn't. So the only thing I could think, and I should probably not say this, but I think it's the whole, there aren't a ton of Asian actors, so we got to give Asian actors now all these awards to make up for our terrible whiteness. So it was like, I mean, are you going to compare what she did to, like, I don't know, all these other great actors and actresses that came before that did these amazing, that, because that was not nowhere near an amazing acting part compared to. So anyway, I'm okay with it if you're going to not follow the structure, but it better be something unique and unique enough that's good. So applying that to this song, yes, I harp on the fact that you got to have, like, a home base. Then you can explore and then come back to the home base. I totally get that. And I think that's exactly what you're supposed to do. And if you don't want to follow that, then it better be something crazy. And that was not. That was a lot of great parts that just, like, and especially to top it off, it shouldn't have been 10 minutes long of that. If you're going to do that and you're not going to follow, like, the typical structure, then in my opinion, it should be 5 minutes, maybe, at the most. If that song was 4 or 5 minutes, then maybe I would have had a different reaction to it. But for it being 10 minutes long, lots of great parts, lots of cool riffs, but it didn't really have a home base for me. So, yeah, that's just my opinion, but all movies across all cultures and all times follow the same freaking steps. They do. You have, like, conflicts that rise to a climax, and that climax either goes bad or good, and then it has, like, a resolution. You got to kind of have that. That's the story. That's music, too. I think it applies to music as well. So I don't think this is a cultural American thing. I think this is the way stories have been told since the beginning of time. Bible times have this sort of same storytelling, the Quran, all that stuff. So anyway, let's move on. You already know what the freaking next song is. It's by Adrian, and it's by my favorite band at the moment, along with Haken. Let's see if this Firefly from Bloom, which, by the way, in Bloom, I think I'm, like, getting through Bloom. I just started Bloom, and I already did Marigold, and then I got to do the next one. So this one is called Fireflight.
Stop. stars will fade, sun will rise, but I'll remember you were my firelight.
Dude, talk about going right into the best parts. You feel to it. That bass sounds so fucking thick. Raise your voices. Noticing how when he said that, raise your voice, and it like raised. Fucking brilliant. Ooh, dum, 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 dum. Dude, that bass sounds fantastic. Yeah, see? Right back to the verse. This is why they're my number one band. Because they did everything that I just got done complaining about. Dude, this fucking song is immediately going to my playlist. It's gonna explode, I feel it. Not explode, but it. Yes, see? Hook, hook, hook my soul. I mean, I didn't know that was going to happen, but that basically just justified me. That just justified everything I talked about. And let me just say, I can't think of a better bass sound that I've heard by anybody. and that even by Caligula's Horse than what I just heard in this song. I mean, even in Dream the Dead, that ending part where it keeps doing that, it sounds good, but something about the way this was engineered in this song, damn, that just like, that bass sounded so fantastic. Man, it just sounded so good. The engineering of it, like, it's not like, I'm not saying his playing necessarily was so fantastic. It was good, but it just, the sound of the bass just sounded so freaking powerful and good and didn't, it's just a perfect balance for me. So, yeah, great choice, Adrian. I think you knew that you weren't going to go wrong with that song with me because that was just, man, that, and I said it in the thing, like, again, there's like levels of writing that are just brilliant in any art. And when you've got him saying, like, let your voice basically go up, and then his voice is going up as he's saying that, that is a level of genius in writing. Like, it's not, and you can tell it's planned, you can tell it's thought out, and it makes sense. And yeah, I think it's, this is why Caligula's Horse is my favorite band at the moment, along with Haken. So they just, I've said this in the past in other videos, I think that Haken's one up over Caligula's Horse is their heavy stuff and their more progressive stuff. But I think Caligula's Horse's one up over Haken is their choruses and their melodies and their ability to capture the heavens in their songs. And this is a perfect example. It's just so heavenly and so beautiful how they write. And they could repeat that many times and I would still cry. So, nice job, Adrian. Adrian is up next. And let's see what band, since I haven't, you know, spilled it for you by clicking the wrong one. Let's see what band this is from Adrian. Ghost Mile. Okay, I guess we're the heavy. Ooh, ticket.
I get that sense that when we look around.
Yes, I had to blur the video so it doesn't get blocked. We'll see if it still gets blocked. Nice change there with the drums. Yeah, see, back to the half. Dude, this like riff, these riffs are really good. I'm liking this. Adrian, you're picking some good shit. Ooh, chickens. The engineering to the song is really good, like that dome, really, when he hits his toms. I like this song a lot. I feel like the chorus has like a 80s feel, but the riffs and heaviness of it have like a updated feel. Yeah, I like it. Blast beats out your ass! I like how they're keeping the melody the same with blast beats underneath. Oh, shit. Damn. I like this. Hell yeah, man. We have to... see? Dude, they're doing a great job going back and forth between the subdivisions. Keeping your brain awake, like I've talked about. Unlike Sasha, I really like the effects on his voice. I think it sounds good. Hell yeah, is that the first time I've heard Voyager? I think that might be the first time I've heard Voyager. I don't know. But I don't remember if we've heard Voyager before, and I definitely like I said, the updated sound of like the heaviness part, but like I feel like a lot of the melody and sound of the voice and harmonies are very 80s-ish, which I like. I love that. Kind of reminds me of like Deep Purple, or maybe not Deep Purple. Who can I think about? I can't think of their name. I can't think of their name. So maybe it'll come back to me later. But it's got like that mix for me that I like. I like the rhythms. I like how they kept changing the subdivisions so that it keeps your mind awake, keeps you like interested in what's going on. Very well written song. Definitely going on my, I would call that a gym playlist song, because it's got that like those heavy, that heaviness definitely makes me like get into it and push out a few more sets or a few more reps in a set. So, well, Adrian, you are 2 for 2 today. I told you it's a battle between you and Jeff now for picking, like, was it Jeff? No, it was somebody else. Cliff. It's between you and Cliff for who's got maybe the best picks for pay for plays. And you just added 2 more to yours, so good job. So you said... yeah, this is my first time hearing them. Yeah, I think this is the first time I've heard them too. But again, there's so many songs on here, and I've had so many times where I'm like, I think this is the first time I've heard these guys. And then I'm like, oh shit, there's like somebody brings up how I listened to them like 1.5 years ago or something. So, all right, so we are moving on. And next up is going to be Colin. Colin says that he's got 2 choices here. And in those 2 choices, the first that we're going to do is, let's see what he says. Defecto, and their song is called Rings of Saturn. So he says this song is a great example of prog and power metal being blended. So I'm interested in hearing this prog and power metal being blended from Rings of Saturn by Defecto. So here we go, Defecto. Jeff, you have some great bands that you pick. Okay. Sounds like Sir Russell a little bit. Yeah, wake up. Building. Nice. I hear the prog and power metal connection. Yes. Hell yeah, man. I'm liking this, man. Like, dude, I'm probably gonna piss you off, Colin, but that part sounded like Five Finger Death Punch or something. See? Yes. Here's the prog part. This part. They needed to pull that guitar more up. It was too far back in the mix. Yeah, this part totally sounds like Five Finger Death Punch. But I like it. I like Five Finger Death Punch for the gym for sure. Ooh. Good. Do this. Colin, you're right on when you say it's a good mix of prog and power metal. Perfect, perfect description. I love the harmonies. And it's in half. See, and they keep going back to this. Kick it, baby. This. It's building too. The So yeah, I'm definitely down for that. That was some really good stuff. I think you described it perfectly, Colin, when you said it's a mix of like power metal or heavier metal, I guess, and like prog stuff. And Mr. Lungman asked, how is the, what is he, where does he say it? What's prog about the harmony parts? For me anyway, and I think there is a debate on what prog is, and if you, I know Paravarium is very kind of like spastic about like people getting it wrong. But for me, I've always said that they're, you know, Prague is pretty big. But I think a clear staple of Prague is technicality. A clear staple of Prague is like in the range. I've always put it on two sides, and I've always said on one side is like your Meshuggah type of stuff, where it's like heavy, repetitive, with this, a lot of the same parts, not very melodic at all, just very heavy and straight. And then I think on the other side of Prague is like your Yes Genesis style, which is less technical, but still very, like, not in your normal pop kind of, you know, they pick different chords, they pick like interesting ideas to go along with how they produce the song. And the harmonies are very, you know, Yes Genesis. So to me, why I said the voice parts, how many Meshuggah songs have you heard fucking, you know, harmonies like that? You don't hear that in Meshuggah songs because it's not that style. So to me, typical power metal style would be like just straight, like, you know, high pitched, whatever, screaming song and like fast guitars and fast rhythms. But this had like that, and then it broke into like more of your Yes Genesis kind of like voice parts and harmonies that are very melodically driven, less technical, and it kind of put both of those together in a song. To me, that is, yeah. That is a perfect mix of Yes Genesis style and some power metal stuff. So, good description, Colin. I think it was great. Ironically, I was thinking like, how do I say this? I would guess a lot of prog snobs would be like against Five Finger Death Punch and stuff like that. And like I've said, I like all sorts of things if it's good to me and it like fits a certain category. Like I typically like more of those like heavy, whatever, like pop songs for like the gym. I usually listen to it in the gym because it gets me going. And I'll just give you an idea of some of the stuff that I listen to at the gym. So on my playlist, I have Anodyne Sea by As I Lay Dying. So As I Lay Dying, there's a lot of their songs because they have a lot of heavy, fast stuff. Lamb of God is on there. Let's see who else. Critical Acclaim by Avenged Sevenfold, which I don't typically love them, but they have some really kick-ass songs. Let's see who else is on here. Oh, I can't think of, where's that band's name? Yep, and then we've got Five Finger Death Punch is on here. Let's see. This is so funny that I'm looking at this, because a lot of these bands are, Volbeat. Yes, there's another one, Volbeat. And I would think Volbeat would be totally made fun of by prog fans. Like, oh man, they're not. Man, Volbeat, you listen to Volbeat, but A Day to Remember, their song Dead and Buried is just freaking sick. Like, it just gets me going. So A Day to Remember, some Slipknot stuff I like, and of course Five Finger Death Punch is on there again. So this just gives you an idea, like, and I would guess in the prog world, they'd be like, oh my god, I can't believe they listen to that stuff, you know? But to me, it's like, you know, in its own, and you know what? I think Odin, how do you say it? I always forget this shit. Odin Ogun has been going into my playlist for the gym playlist as well. If it's heavy, it's typically going to go on my gym playlist. So, all right. So Colin has another song for us, and it's our last song for the day. He said it's pronounced Kiwas. And he said it's a Finnish metal band that's hard to describe. It's almost like if Opeth played power metal. Okay. Very interesting. And this song is called The New Chapter. So we're going to end with Kiwas. Kiwas. All right. Here we go. Kiwas. Okay. Yeah. I like it. Ooh, love that change. Not a fan of the song or the sound of the voice yet. Nice. Dude, that's some sick freaking rhythm stuff. No matter. Oh, I like that. I think Sasha's gonna like this. And guess what? I don't like the singing. I like the guitars. I like the rhythms. The riffs. Not really on the, I like that. Keyboard and guitar together. Of course you do, Sasha. Good, good note there. Yeah, Colin, I would say I don't hear the opus much. Dude, I love their guitars. They sound good. Yeah, it's like, and see, they're repeating. Good song structure. This part's a little power metal cheesy to me. Dude, I love that. Yes, nice guitar. Yes. Good solo there. Liked it. Very well done. Ooh, that was cool. All right, I mean, I think everything's been said that is what I think, which I think is so funny. I want to make something very clear to the people that are watching this or listening to this. I'm going to say this a lot because I want to make sure everyone knows this, especially if they just come in here for one video and then they leave. This channel is about opening my mind to new stuff. And I think all of us are here because we have our tastes, but it's good to hear your tastes. And maybe your taste won't change all that much. Kind of like, I don't know, maybe your political views or something like that. You have your political views or your beliefs about certain things. But hearing other stuff is a healthy, healthy endeavor for life in general about everything. And I think this is the problem with the United States in particular. Is that window of hearing and being able to listen to other points of view and other thoughts and other ideas is getting smaller and smaller and smaller in like the free world, you know? That's what's sad about what's happening in the United States, is it's supposed to be the free world, but it's turning into the most constricted world. And I think even if like this stuff or the cheesiness or the whatever it may be is not my particular taste right away, and maybe it never will be, that's not the point. The point is being exposed to other stuff on a consistent basis. And what I think is funny about this is it's almost like a clear cut, not completely, but it's almost a clear cut that like whatever Sasha says, I'm going to be on the other side of it. And whatever I say, Sasha's going to be on the other side of it. And Colin is almost like Sasha, but like kind of a little more maybe, I don't know, in between me and Sasha a little bit. But those two are, and I would say Adrian, I agree. John, Feedy, and I tend to agree on a lot of stuff. So it, to me, I love the connection between all of that, how we all kind of can tell what our tastes are. But there are a lot of things on here that I've already learned to like that I probably wouldn't have ever liked or seen or heard if it wasn't for this channel. So to me, this is awesome. But as far as this song in particular, I think my initial feeling is don't like the vocals. I think they're kind of cheesy, especially in the chorus part. But the freaking instrumentation is totally awesome. Like, I wish I could kind of bleed out the vocals enough to just like take this and put it on a gym playlist. So if there's an instrumental part of this song that's somewhere on YouTube, let me know or give me a link, because I'm going to definitely download, because they are very tight. They are, and it wasn't like, even power metal riffs and stuff like that kind of get too boring and redundant to me. At least this song, I didn't feel like that. I felt like the riffs were pretty unique as far as like, and very well done. And not quote unquote typical. So yeah, we got through another 5 songs today, but that doesn't mean we're done, people. We still have tomorrow night with another 5 songs, and then we already have next Friday set up. So it looks like at this point, the way things are going, if they continue to go this way, we're gonna be doing videos on Friday, Saturday morning, Sunday morning, and Monday. And then depending on if it slows down or whatever, then one of those days will just go away. Monday will always be consistent. So if you can be here tomorrow night at 7:30, I know for you European people that's going to be a little late, but if you can, join us and let's keep going on this ride together. And some great songs today. As always, I will always give these songs a second listen. And as I give them a second listen, maybe they'll change and maybe they'll grow on me. And that's the whole point. And that's the thing that I look forward to about this channel and what you guys suggest. So have a great Sunday. For those of you who are at late Sunday, Monday's coming. We all don't enjoy Monday, I'm guessing. And I'm not either. So especially with it raining all day today. So all right, you guys have a good one. Peace out.